students, today we are dealing with the topic
double circulation.
Our heart undergoes double circulation. We have the circulatory system as a double circulation. That means the two times the heart receives the blood. Now we'll study in detail. The body parts except from the lungs the deoxygenated blood is received by the first chamber of the heart, that is right auricle. Here, what is in the deoxygenated blood? The deoxygenated blood is nothing but carbon dioxide rich blood. From the body parts, the superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, and coronary sinus, also called as coronary veins. Coronary sinus we call or coronary veins. So superior vena cava will carry the deoxygenated blood from the upper parts of the body, that is above the abdomen part, and the inferior vena cava will carry the deoxygenated blood from the lower parts of the body, that is below the abdomen part, and the coronary veins will collect the deoxygenated blood from the muscles of the heart. So the blood reaches, the deoxygenated blood reaches the right auricle. Now from the right auricle, the blood will move on to the right ventricle. Which is the second chamber of the heart. Deoxygenated blood will move into the right ventricle. When the right auricle sends the blood to the right ventricle, so the tricuspid wall will be opened. Next, from the right ventricle, the blood flows into the lungs. Why the blood will flow into the lungs? Because for the exchange of the gases, to purify the gases. In lungs, the alveoli structure, this is the alveoli, single alveoli structure, which will be surrounded with of capillaries. So from the capillaries, the CO2 will enter into the alveoli. The spherical shape is alveoli and this is the capillary. So from the capillary, the carbon dioxide is given to the alveoli so that we will exhale it out through the windpipe and nostrils. And the oxygen which we inhale, it reaches the alveoli, and from the alveoli the oxygen will reach into the capillaries. Now from the capillaries again it enters the heart. Now from the right ventricle to the lungs, who will carry the deoxygenated blood? The deoxygenated blood is carried by pulmonary artery. Who will carry the blood vessel that carries the deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle into the lungs? Through pulmonary artery. Now I told you what happens in the lungs, that is exchange of gases will take place, oxygen and the carbon dioxide. Now from the lungs, the purified blood from the lungs the purified blood. So what do you call the purified blood as? Oxygenated blood. This oxygenated blood will enter the third chamber, that is the left auricle. Now who will carry from lungs to left auricle this oxygenated blood? That is pulmonary vein. All the veins carries deoxygenated blood, but only pulmonary vein will carry the oxygenated blood from the lungs. Similarly, all the arteries will carry the oxygenated blood, but only pulmonary artery will carry the deoxygenated blood. Now, from the left auricle, the blood flows into the last chamber, that is left ventricle. Now here the bicuspid wall, will be opened to send the blood from a left auricle to the left ventricle. What kind of blood is carried from left auricle to the left ventricle? That is oxygenated blood. It is a purified blood. Now next, from the left ventricle to all parts of the body, the blood moves. That is the oxygenated blood. The oxygenated blood will move into the all body parts through the largest artery, that is aorta. Through aorta, the oxygenated blood will reach to all parts of the body. So this is the flow of the blood in the heart, between the heart, lungs and the body parts. This will summarize the blood from the body parts, that is deoxygenated blood is carried into the right auricle. From the right auricle, it reaches to the right ventricle, and from the right ventricle, it reaches the lungs. In the lungs, the exchange of gases will take place. Carbon dioxide is taken from the blood and oxygen is added to the blood, and the blood vessel, that is pulmonary vein, will carry the oxygenated blood in passage to the left auricle, and from the left auricle the blood moves to the left ventricle, and from the left ventricle it is supplied to all parts of the body. Now here you can see is that the two types of circulation we can see, that is systemic circulation systemic circulation is nothing but the circulation of the blood between the body parts and the heart. Is nothing but called as circulation, that is systemic circulation. So our circulatory system, that is our circulation, is of double circulation. Why it is called double circulation? Because once the blood will undergo circulation with body parts and the heart. And second kind of circulation is that pulmonary circulation. Why here the term pulmonary used? That is the exchange of the blood takes between the lungs and the heart. So we call pulmonary circulation. So this part of the circulation is the systemic circulation, and this part of the circulation is the pulmonary circulation. So between the body parts and the heart we call systemic circulation, and the circulation between the lungs and the heart we call it as pulmonary circulation. Next, we'll study about the cardiac cycle, that is heart and heartbeat. So what is cardiac cycle? The cardiac cycle is nothing but the sequence of the event that takes place in the heart during the heartbeat, that is during the flow of the blood in the chambers. cardiac cycle, a sequence. Of event that takes in the heart, that takes in the heart during the flow of blood with pressure. In the chambers, I think so. It's enough in the flow of the blood. This is nothing but called as cardiac cycle. Next is heartbeat. Heartbeat is nothing but it's a rhythmic contraction, relaxation of the heart. It's a rhythmic contraction and relaxation of the heart. Contraction and relaxation means, the term contraction we also call it as systole, and the relaxation is diastole. That means one cardiac cycle is complete, one contraction and one relaxation of the heart chambers. That is the rhythmic contraction relaxation of the heart. Heart is nothing but the heart chamber. That is the auricles and the ventricles. Is nothing but called as the cardiac cycle. Now here you can see that the alternate terms, that is systole is nothing but contraction and the diastole is nothing but the relaxation. Now, our heart beats 72 times per minute. Our heart beats 72 times per minute. Each heartbeat takes 0.8 seconds. It is the complete cardiac cycle ends in 0.8 seconds. So now here in this module, we will study about the three stages in the cardiac cycle. Totally we have three phases. First one is joint diastole. Second one is atrial systole, and third one is ventricular systole. So we study three phases here. One is joint diastole. Joint diastole means that both auricles and the ventricles, this upper chambers and the lower chamber, that is the ventricles, they undergo diastole, means they will be in a relaxed condition. Both upper chamber and lower chamber, they will be in a relaxed condition. And next, atrial systole, that is upper chamber, will contract and when upper chamber will be contract, lower chamber will be relaxed. And in third phase, ventricle systole, that is lower chamber will contract. So during that time, the upper chamber will be relaxed. So we'll study these three in detail now. During the joint diastole, the atrial and the ventricular diastole, that is relaxation, will take place. So this thing, upper chamber and the lower chamber, they will be in a relaxed condition. Auricles, ventricles, both are in a relaxed condition. Now in the second phase, atrial systole. When atrial systoles, the ventricular part, that is the lower chamber, will get relaxed. Ventricles relax. That is diastole. You will see the picture. You can see here the auricle part is contracting and the ventricle part is relaxed. It means the auricles will become small and they will contract, the muscles of the auricles will contract and the ventricles will diastole. So during this, what happens in the chamber? First thing is that the atria, that is auricles, auricle muscles contracts, auricle muscles contracts, and second thing is that the opening, that is the tricuspid wall and the bicuspid wall, will get open. I'll show the visualization picture here. Auricle, ventricle. So when auricles contract to send the maximum blood into the ventricles, you can see the arrow mark here, the blood is flowing downwards. So during this, the tricuspid wall and the bicuspid wall will get open. So tricuspid wall and bicuspid wall opens. So when tricuspid wall and bicuspid wall opens, what happens to the semilunar walls? Before semilunar walls, we will talk about the superior vena cava wall, inferior vena cava wall and the pulmonary wall, pulmonary vein wall. This is superior vena cava, this is pulmonary vein and this is inferior vena cava. So the blood, when it is contract, when it is busy in sending the blood into the ventricles part, the blood should not flow back into the walls. So, the superior vena cava opening, pulmonary opening, and the inferior opening will be closed. Closure of superior opening of closure of opening of superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, and the pulmonary vein. Even the coronary veins also will be closed. Next thing. Now what happens to the pulmonary artery? As you all know that the T-shaped blood vessel will arise. The T-shaped blood vessel will arise from the left ventricle. Similarly, the aorta will arise from the right ventricle, and the aorta will arise from the left ventricle. So these valves together we call it as semilunar valves. The opening of the pulmonary artery and the aorta, so both we call it as semilunar valves. So this semilunar valves will be closed. Semilunar valves, that is pulmonary artery and the aortic semilunar valves, will be closed. When the closure of the semilunar valves takes place, we can hear the sound is, that is dup. We can hear the sound that is dup. And right here, the sound we hear when the semilunar valve gets closed is sound is dup. So this is nothing but the atrial systole and the ventricular diastole. And third part is that is ventricle systole. When ventricular part systoles, that is and draw here. The auricle patch will be relaxed, that is undergoes diastole. You can see here the shape of the auricle. It's the muscles are coming near and they are squeezing, they are becoming small, so that the ventricles will systole, that is it contracts, and the auricle will get relaxed. So now what happens in the chamber when ventricle systoles? Alternately, for the atrial diastole will takes place. What happens to the wall? That is, first thing is that the ventricle contracts. Ventricle contracts and they become small. The second thing is that what happens to the tricuspid wall and the bicuspid wall? The tricuspid wall and the bicuspid wall will be closed. You can see in the picture here. will get close. So there is no way for the blood to flow. That is this auricles, ventricles, because the blood is moving into the can see the arrow mark. The blood is moving to the pulmonary artery and the aorta. So now the tricuspid wall, when the bicuspid wall will get closed, because when ventricles contract, the blood should not flow back into the auricle chamber. It is the upper chamber. To prevent that, the tricuspid wall and the bicuspid wall will get closed. So during this, we can hear the sound, that is lub. What happened to the semilunar walls? The semilunar walls, that is the pulmonary artery and the aorta, will get open because they have to receive the blood and they have to transport it to the lungs and other body parts for the circulation. And what happens to the walls here? That is superior vena cava, pulmonary vein, inferior vena cava. These walls will get open. That means the blood will be flowing. So, superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, and pulmonary veins will get open. So, once again, we'll summarize. During atrial systole, the auricle muscles, sorry, this is spelling mistake here. The auricle muscles contracts, whereas during the ventricle systole, the ventricle muscles will contract. Ventricles muscles will contract. And during the atrial systole, the tricuspid wall, bicuspid wall will be open. You can see here, it is open, so that the auricles will contract and send the blood to the ventricle part. And during the ventricle systole, you can see that tricuspid wall and the bicuspid will get close, because the blood is flowing from the ventricle into the pulmonary artery and the aorta, so that to prevent the backflow of the blood, this wall will get closed. During the closure of the tricuspid wall and the bicuspid wall, here we hear the sound, that is the lub. And next thing is that we can see the closure of opening of superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, and the pulmonary vein. So here these walls will get closed, so that to prevent the backflow of the blood. And similarly, the semilunar walls also will get closed to prevent the backflow of the blood. But here, all these four walls will get open at a time. So this is nothing but the cardiac cycle that takes place, that is systole and diastole phase takes place in our heart chambers.